Gel electrophoresis is the process used to separate fragments of DNA according to their size and shape. In this example, genetically engineered plasmids from a ligation reaction are mixed with a solution that contains both a viscous or syrupy liquid, often glycerol, and dyes, bromophenol blue and orange G. The viscous liquid is heavier than the buffer and allows the DNA samples to sink into the narrow wells of the gel. The dyes help researchers track the progress of the DNA fragments as they migrate through the gel. When electrical current is applied to the gel, the DNA fragments, which have a negative charge, migrate through the gel from the negative electrode toward the positive. Two principal factors affect how quickly a piece of DNA will migrate through agarose gel: its overall size and its shape. The larger the piece, the more slowly it will move. The more compact a fragment, the faster it will move. Solutions containing plasmids of identical size and sequence can still result in multiple bands on an agarose gel. This is because plasmids can take on different shapes, depending on how they are coiled. Once gel electrophoresis is completed, the gel is placed over an ultraviolet light source to reveal the position of the DNA samples. The samples appear as glowing bands throughout the gel because the DNA has been stained with ethidium bromide, a small molecule that inserts within the DNA double helix and can be visualized under UV light. The DNA ladder is a mix of DNA fragments of known sizes, which helps determine the sizes of the DNA fragments in the other samples. The control lanes carry the original, uncut, and cut plasmids, which migrate at a different rate when compared to the recombinant plasmid. The control samples confirm that the sixth lane actually contains recombinant plasmid.